Yeah, you're watching Parker Vision right here with Future Hendrix. Turn up, never turn down. I'm just being honest.
You already know what it is, man. Parker Vision's in full effect right now. Out here at Carolina Kitchen. I'm with the man, Future. Bro, how are you feeling right now?
Man, I'm feeling great. I'm feeling great, man. The album about to drop, you know what I'm saying, on Tuesday, 4/22/14. So everything's well.
Yeah, this is kind of like a long-awaited project for you. I feel like you've been out here really killing for a couple of years, man, with this. A lot of people make songs. You've really been able to craft a sound. And when I hear people, when I hear the other guys, I'm not going to name names, but I hear the other guys influenced. You're really kind of leading a generation with this sound right now. You know what I mean? Talk about the inspiration for this harmonizing, singing thing that's become a staple right now in the culture.
I find my inspiration from different places, you know what I'm saying? I try to stay outside the box or whatever. I try to just listen to different kind of music. I always listen to rap. Just be inspired, man, and be creative as possible. Just from just noise in the streets to a car cranking up. You just try to find anything to be creative and be inspired from. Conversations with friends in the studio or whatnot, and it just sparked my interest in going in the booth and just doing something special.
Totally unique, you know what I mean? How did coming up in like a Dungeon Family type setting help in this process? Were you inspired by that? I mean, obviously Dungeon Family is like legendary type shit, you know?
Yeah, most definitely being inspired by that. Just tell my cousin, just let me know, man. You just be inspired by anything, use it for inspiration to feed off, you know what I'm saying, negative, positive energy, whatever it is, man, at that time, just be able to create moments through your music.
Yeah, that's what it really is, man. Why'd you change the name of the album?
Just connecting with the fans, you know what I mean? I had to take a step back so I can take more steps further, you know what I mean? Help them connect the lines with the Future Hendrix and why I feel like I'm Future Hendrix and why the music is what it is on Future Hendrix. I had to make sure I connected with the Day One fans, my mixtape fans, and the fans that have been holding me down from day one. That's been wanting to just hit old same damn tiebreakers, the Magics, and then try to cover more ground on songs like I Be You and I Won to set up for Future Hendrix later on.
Definitely, man. I see a lot of great features on this album. Your man Drake is definitely a part of this. I know you guys had some things last year. I'm really glad to see that behind you. You know, how is your relationship right now with Drizzy? All positive, right?
It's all positive, you know what I mean? I haven't spoke to him, but it's all good.
Yeah, no, it's good to see that kind of like happen, but then be squashed. You know what I mean? It's bigger than that, you know what I mean?
Man, way bigger than that. Ain't no issues.
Most definitely, that's really positive, man. So, okay, I knew you were behind Drunken Love. You know, I knew that you were kind of the man behind Beyonce's probably comeback record in a lot of ways. Are we ever going to get a chance to hear the original Good Morning? I'm really like, that's something that intrigues me, this original record that you wrote. That it was similar melodies, something different, your version of it.
I don't know if it get leaked or something that just happened to come out. But besides that, man, I'm not even tripping off that, you know what I mean? It wasn't like she stole it from me or it was my record at first. It was like, man, I was just working with a producer on the record. I was just, so it is what it is, you know what I mean? I don't try to focus on it. I know they try to put a lot of negative light on that song, you know? It feels like it's a great thing, you know? It's the number one record for
behind that, like to be next to that energy. It's a Beyonce, you know what I mean? Like, it's beautiful.
Yeah, during that course of time, we made a few records during that course of time, so even the records that came out during that time, man, it's been some special joints.
I wanted to say congratulations on your upcoming child, man. It's a wonderful thing. You and Sierra seem to have like something really special, you know, and I haven't talked about it yet, and I'm having my first child coming up in 2 months, a daughter for the first time. I haven't talked about it on a record or radio or anything, and it's an amazing, amazing thing to see this when you got your girl and your lover, and then all of a sudden it's just this person, this other person is in the room with you guys, you know what I mean? The baby's moving. It's wild, right?
Like, yeah, man. It makes you like wild at times, but you know what I'm saying? It's happening. And right now I'm promoting the album, but at the same time, you know, that's always at the forefront of my mind. Like,
I'm here with you right now, talking right now, but it's like it's something new.
Yeah, it's something new, and it can happen any day. So I'm always on alert.
Have you come up with a name or anything? You guys know what you're going to do?
Yeah, we got the name.
It's beautiful, man. Congratulations, man.
Thank you.
How does your children and this child in particular, you know, helping you evolve as a man?
Just make you feel like you want to just make sure you be a good representative for your for all your kids. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So you just got to move through and maneuver through life different. But it's a great thing, you know what I'm saying? Growth, when you show growth, man, it's a great thing, man. You got to embrace it.
Nah, it's beautiful, man. 2-3 years ago, I remember somebody saying to me, "Hey, you know, you ever heard of Future?" And I'm like, "What are you talking about?" And now to be here with you and a hip hop superstar that made such a dent in the industry and a staple that's going to be around, you're going to be around forever, bro. And congratulations on all your hard work and all your efforts. Next Tuesday, album, Honest. Talk about it, man. Tell them what it is. Tell them why they need to go pick it up, man.
Man, go and pick the album up, man, because there's some incredible music on here. I promise you, from the beginning to the end, even on the deluxe version, you got to go and get the album, 422-14. It's been a long time coming, 2 years since I dropped my last album, and it's still great music. I'm still putting out new music and changing the radio, changing the sound, yeah, creating that trend. Love.
And you're not even afraid to go to that Move That Dope. Like, that sound like No Limit. Like, that's so crazy. You can go this way and that way. Like,
exactly. Just reinvent. I always stress reinvent yourself time after time. You know what I'm saying? Even right now, you're just going in the studio and knowing what's the next hit to come.
You definitely sold me on you as an artist, and I believe in what you're doing. And I just want to say congratulations, man. Oh, man, it's love. Parker Vision, you already know what it is.